Sports, a place where many athletes find success.
This is likely the final play that matters. End zone wide open. What a night for Mike Williams.
But where there's a winner, there has to be a loser.
We came a long way. You hear me? Come here, I love you, bro.
It's one thing to watch the game, but another to analyze it. Let's talk about the numbers. You ready?
YouTube! What's going on, man? Back here to give another video. It's your boy, Numbers Fan Jay. And I told you guys that I was coming with another topic. Of course, we're here. Today, we're going to talk about what I think has been the fall of ESPN. A very slow decline. It's not, you know, it's not in the dirt. It's still clearly on TV, has its own channel, all of that stuff. But I feel like ESPN is trending in the wrong direction. And we're going to explain why. So before we get into the explanation, the analysis of ESPN and their decline, please leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell for your boy. Show me some love. Share this video with your family, your friends. Let's get this discussion going because I don't think enough people are talking about this. I think that we're all really fed up with the lack of topics from ESPN, ESPN First Take, or anything regarding ESPN, more specifically concerning basketball, right? So let's get into it. So, I took the liberty to go ahead and review the last 30 topics that ESPN has uploaded to YouTube. And I did this because a lot of our generation is centered around technology. And it's more so personal technology, tablets, phones, laptops, you know, things that we can take with us, things that we can, you know, look at and do in our spare time, maybe on our lunch break at work or things like that. We really don't sit down and watch TV like the previous generation did. So I just felt like bringing YouTube topics would be more relevant to us. It would really explain, you know, what they're trying to do or what I think they're trying to do. And if we're actually interested in it. So I took the last 30 topics, which is the full 24 hours of what ESPN has uploaded to YouTube. And the lack of diversity in these topics, man, it's not surprising. It's not surprising at all. I've talked with several of my friends. We're sick of hearing the same conversations all the time. And I think y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. So out of the last 30 topics, 9 of those videos have been directly related to the Lakers or LeBron James. The next closest topic has been talked about five times. And that's been the Tim Tebow topic. Of course, Tim Tebow recently being headed to the Jacksonville Jaguars as a tight end. And he hasn't played in the league for 8 years, but that's a whole different topic. But anyway, so the problem with this is, that's a 24-hour span, right? There were 0 videos about the Phoenix Suns, the Utah Jazz, the Denver Nuggets. These are 3 of the 4 top teams in the West. The Lakers are 7th. They are 7th in the West. I understand LeBron James has been the face of the NBA. I understand. I understand that he's been in most of the championships for the last decade. He went to 9 straight. I get it. I get it. But at the same time, there is so much more to talk about. Speaking of the Lakers being 7th in the West, there have been 0 topics on the 7th seeded Celtics in the East. So if you're gonna show love to one 7th seed team, show it to the other. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like it's so much more to talk about, but looking into the topics that they have decided to cover, Tim Tebow, like I said, has been covered 5 times in the last 24 hours. Curry has been covered 4 times. Another guy that they cover a lot. Russell Westbrook has only been covered twice, even though he's broken the triple-double record all time. Surprising. Bradley Beal and Kent Bazemore, their beef or whatever, has been covered two times. Aaron Rodgers has been covered once. The Celtics have been covered once. Actually, you know what? I just said the Celtics have been covered once. They've been covered once. I'm sorry. I misspoke earlier. I said zero. They've been covered once. The Lakers have been covered six times. Just the Lakers being in the headline of the video. LeBron has been covered one time. Just being LeBron so-and-so, so-and-so. LeBron versus MJ / the GOAT conversation has been covered twice in the past 24 hours, even though there's no reason to really be talking about that right now. His career isn't over. We're in the middle of a season. We're not even in the playoffs. I mean, come on. Like I said, the Suns, the Nuggets, and the Jazz have not been talked about at all. Right? There have been zero updates on the recently drafted NFL players. There have been zero videos about the NBA play-in tournament that has to take place before the playoffs. There were 10 other NBA games on last night besides the Knicks and the Lakers, and none of those were covered. The other sports, which, you know, we got baseball, we got soccer, other sports are, you know, nothing has been covered about that in 2 days. It's been 2 days since they've covered anything besides basketball and a little bit of football. I mean, the NFL schedule releases tonight. As of 11:12 a.m., there has been one video in the past 24 hours about the NFL schedule being released. The schedule releases tonight at 7 p.m. Central Time. As of 11:12 Central Time, it's only been one video. This is the thing, man. Like, ESPN is the entertainment and sports programming network. Why are we just talking about the Lakers and LeBron? You have so much more to cover. And this is what you're giving our generation. This is why a lot of us aren't really tuning in anyway. So it's like we have to go to Twitter and Facebook and Instagram to start our own conversations, and it has to be content creators putting out posts for us to actually talk about something besides LeBron James, the Lakers, and the NBA GOAT debate. There's so much more to talk about. And, you know, I've been a fan. Once you learn about the NBA, once you learn about MJ, once you learn about LeBron, Kobe, and all of those guys, Shaq, you're gonna wanna talk about the GOAT debate. But eventually, you're going to say, all right, what else do we have to talk about? Because you're not going to walk in a room for a week straight just going, well, who do you think is the GOAT? Because you just had that conversation yesterday. You just had that conversation a few days ago. Like, what else is there to talk about? Can we talk about the new guys? Let's talk about Zion. Let's talk about Luka. Let's talk about Ja. Let's talk about what are the Celtics going to do without Jaylen Brown? Like, it's so much more, man. We're not getting enough from the station that we all grew up on. And we were ready to tune in every morning. Every Monday morning after NFL football Sunday, we tuned in. Every game, every morning after NBA Finals game, we're tuned in. Every morning after a series ends in the NBA, we're tuned in. And now we're not really doing it. We'd rather just talk amongst ourselves because they're not going to cover the things that we think need to be covered. Chris Paul has been maybe the most influential player outside of LeBron James in the past 4 or 5 years. And he's been on multiple teams. He's made all of those teams better. We don't talk about that. Damian Lillard, always being forced into the conversation with Steph Curry. But he's not nearly as efficient as Steph Curry. But we talk about Curry, we don't talk about the inefficiencies of Damian Lillard. Even though so many people want him to be as good as Steph. So it's like, I'm a good Lord, man. Can we get something else? Let's talk about other things. You know how many different topics I've had on YouTube? I can't even, it will take me forever to go back and count how many different topics I've covered on YouTube. But I mean, goodness. I've made my own, you know, GOAT debate between LeBron and Kobe. I haven't made my LeBron MJ video. I don't even know if I want to make it at this point because it's old, man. It's getting old. Honestly, I've been saying that I want to wait till LeBron retires before I actually make my video, because then we can look at his career from beginning to end. Just like we can look at MJ's career from beginning to end. I feel like that's a more fair comparison. But anyway, that's all I'm going to leave y'all with for today, man. I had to get my rant out, but goodness gracious. Goodness. As you can see, I recorded this video a day early on Wednesdays. Last week, I do apologize for uploading on Wednesday. I did not try to do that. I had already finished editing, and I was excited to go ahead and release the finale for Football 101. I'm sorry. I'm not going to release this today. I'm going to release this, of course, on Thursdays, which are my usual upload days. Thank y'all for watching. Leave a like, leave a comment, hit that notification bell. Share this video with your family and friends. We're trying to get to 200 subscribers, man. We can do it. Thank y'all for watching, man. It's your boy, Jay. We out of here.